change for the better. Mr. Modi said there was a time when India was part of fragile five economies of the world, and his government pulled it out to make it the fastest growing economy. India and Ethiopia today signed agreements on trade, communication and media to boost bilateral ties. The agreements were signed after wide-ranging talks between President Ramnath Kovind and his Ethiopian counterpart Mulatu Teshome at Addis Ababa in Ethiopia. The two leaders discussed economic relations between the two countries and also support to Ethiopia in the power, healthcare and education sectors. In a series of tweets, Mr. Kovind said, India has created jobs and contributed to the prosperity of Ethiopia. He referred to India as among the top three sources of foreign direct investment for Ethiopia. The president also thanked Ethiopia for its participation in the International Solar Alliance, or ISA, established in 2015. Addressing the India-Ethiopia business dialogue in Addis Ababa, Mr. Kovind said India is now among the top three foreign investors in Ethiopia and its investments have had a significant presence in manufacturing. He said India's relationship with Ethiopia is symbolic of its engagement with the African continent.
I now call upon Ethiopia and India to work together to push for reforms in institutions of international financial and monetary governance and make it relevant to our age. It is only appropriate that such and keen business partners as India and Ethiopia strive together for a more equitable and contemporary global economic architecture.
Air Chief B.S. Manohar today said the Indian Air Force is capable of countering China and ready to take on the challenge of a two-front war. Addressing a press conference in New Delhi on the eve of Air Force Day, the Air Chief Marshal said his force is ready for a full spectrum operation, but added that any decision